one on the left hand, one on the right. His hands will be up above his shoulders. And if he wants to turn left, he pulls down on that left control line. Steering line, the same on the right, to turn back the other way. And just before landing, you're gonna see hands up about shoulder level. And both hands will come down symmetrically, down toward the waist. That changes the shape of the trailing edge of the parachute canopy. They got that putting on the brakes because that actually.
Oh, that's him, he jumped.
Straight up overhead, almost into the sun. That smoke trail that you see is from a smoke grenade that's attached to the boot of the jumper. Straight on down it comes at over 120 miles an hour. Deploying that pilot chute, out comes the main canopy, that beautiful gold and black canopy of the Golden Knights.
MIA flag on this, my 998th freefall parachute jump. I will describe for you today a demonstration of precision freefall as performed by members of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. We now have members of the Golden Knights rapidly approaching speeds of 120 miles per hour. The initial part of the formation is called the base, and it forms quickly as the initial jumpers fly their bodies together, interlocking their arms and legs, forming the nucleus of the formation. The remaining jumpers set up slightly above and outside of the formation, awaiting the team leader's call. At 9,000 feet, The outside jumpers fly to the base. As they fly closer and closer together, they use their hands, arms, legs, and shoulders as flight controls. The jumpers now separate to perform our bombers maneuver. And there you have the high-flying black and gold of yore, United States Army Parachute Team, the Golden Knights.
Woohoo!
The parachutes used by the Golden Knights are flexible wing gliders, constructed of lightweight ripstop nylon. These parachutes have an inherent forward airspeed of 22 miles per hour. The average Golden Knight is 26 years old, has over 1,200 free fall parachute jumps, and is proficient in one of the hundreds of occupational specialties. He or she joined the Army for a multitude of reasons: training, educational benefits, travel, adventure, excitement, a chance to mature. In short, to get ahead on life and be a part of America's finest team without adversely affecting its flight characteristics. The formation you see here is called a two-stack. The top jumper is now in total control of the formation. This leaves the bottom jump person free to grab the next canopy if they should dock from below. Unlike free fall, these jumpers can carry on a conversation just like you and I standing on the ground. It is a job of the bottom jumper, who is the navigator, to relay altitude readings to the pilot. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm round of applause as the first of our jumpers come in for a target landing area. Unlike military jet teams, the United States Army Parachute Team is comprised mostly of non-commissioned officers. The 89 men and women of the Golden Knights come from various jobs throughout the Army to spend 3 years in one of the five major sections of the team. Our administrative support section contains the Office of the Command, Operations, Logistics, Parachute Maintenance, and Media Relations. Our aviation section flies and maintains R2, UV-18, Viking Twin Otters in R2, C-31, French and Bearcat.
Look at these guys here.
Now as you watch the crew, the bottom jumper is kicked up, and they are now coming earthward at 90 miles per hour, and will release just hundreds of feet above the ground. Elite Aviation Section. Nicknamed Team 6, the pilots who fly the team aircraft average more than 5,500 per aviator, and the Navy Sub-Nation, who have a mission in keeping these aircraft running, average more than 10 years military experience. In the future, may all your days be prosperous, yes, and your nights golden.
Yes.